Today, I'll show you how to use the new stem separation tool in FL Studio 21.2 and how to significantly enhance the result with a few simple tricks. So, let's get to it. If this is your first time here and you want to learn all about FL Studio and music production in general, then make sure you hit that subscribe button and the bell as well. For those of you who don't know, stems are basically the individual components of a song, like bass, drums, vocals, and so on, as individual tracks, like this. I've previously used Isotope RX to separate stems. There are also websites that can do this, but having this feature integrated into FL Studio itself is a real game changer. As far as I know, FL Studio is currently the only DAW that has this built in. To split this song into individual stems, just click here and then Extract Stems from Sample. Select the ones you want and click Extract. The song is now split into separate tracks. Baby, you get me midnight. Easy. You whip up my appetite. I don't wanna jinx it, baby. Can't twist myself, that's the spine. This is great if you want to make a remix, for example, and you just need the vocals, or you just want to learn how a song was constructed. Definitely a great learning tool. If I want an instrumental version of the song, I just delete the vocal. Note that it's not perfect. There will always be some degradation. The process is never 100% non-destructive, so it's best to use a high-quality, uncompressed WAV file. I wish it was possible to fine-tune the separation strength and such, like in Isotope RX, perhaps in future versions. It won't always sound great, but you can easily sweeten it up. For example, the drums will often sound a bit dull and muffled. I like to designate each track to a mixer insert. Then add a transient shaper on the drums and bring up the attack a bit. That will instantly make it crisper. Baby. You can also add some EQ. Guitars, pianos, and such will often resonate close to vocals, which can cause the volume to fade in and out. In that case, you can add a compressor to mitigate that. Compression can help glue sounds together. Then reduce the mix amount so that you have about a 50-50 dry and wet signal coming through. This will usually sound more natural. The bass can also end up sounding thin. In that case, I like to use plugins like the Waves R Bass. They introduce extra harmonics in the set frequency, which will make it sound warmer and more natural. Baby, you get me midnight. You whip up my appetite. Because the vocal is almost always on top of the mix, it will usually be the best preserved stem. Still, some compression or an EQ can often help sweeten it up as well.
Baby, you give me ice and fire. You're giving me wind and rain.
Some reverb and slapback delay can, in some cases, help mask any imperfections.
You whip up my appetite. Don't leave me here high and dry. Baby, you can.
Okay, before you go crazy with this, keep in mind that it's illegal to use stems extracted from commercial songs in your own music. You need to have the rights to all samples. That said, uploading an unofficial remix will rarely get anyone in trouble. In most cases, it will be allowed to stay, but any ad revenue will go to the original artist. Just don't try to release anything through DistroKid or anything without permission. Want to know more about how to release your own music and get it on Spotify, etc.? Then check out my DistroKid tutorial. Links are down below. I hope you found this helpful, and if you did, then please like, share, and subscribe. Check out the links below if you need feedback on your music, mastering, and so on. And if you want to support this channel, then consider clicking the thanks button or support us on Patreon. Thanks for watching.